Hi, I'm Rachel Michiko-Whitney with Ideate TV, here with Mary Ting. She's an author. Hi, Mary. How are you?
Hi, Rachel.
So tell us a little bit about how you became an author. Did you always know that you wanted to become one, or what's your story?
This is a very interesting story because every time I get asked this question, I always say no. I never wanted to be an author. It never crossed my mind. But one day, when my grandmother passed away, I had this need to write. I knew that it would help me heal. So I started writing my book, Crossroads. This is the, should I show it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's show it.
So I started writing this book called Crossroads, based on a dream I had in high school. But I was teaching at that time, so I never thought about, I didn't take myself seriously as an author. And so I based it on a dream I had in high school, and I got this idea because I'm a huge Twilight fan, and I know that Stephanie Meyer based her story on a dream that she had. So I thought, well, why not? I'll base it on a dream I had in high school, and then, 25 years later, after my grandmother passed away, I started writing. And I never thought I would finish a book, but with a lot of helps from my friend, I was able to complete one book. And then I didn't think that I would write anymore. I thought this would be it. But emails started pouring in. People started texting me through Facebook and messaging me and asking me if I'm going to write book two. And I thought, okay, why not? So then I worked with a small publisher, and we got the whole series done. And then I started branching off writing under M. Clark. I call them mommy's book. They're a little bit more steamier, but it's a sweet romance. And then after 4 years later, I ended up with 25 books. And I always thought it would be just one. So that's how I became an author.
That's very impressive, because I know how hard it is to just sit down and write sometimes. So congratulations on that.
Thank you. It kind of becomes an obsessive for me, it's like if I don't write, I get grouchy.
Really?
Yeah, I think it's like a way for me to escape as well.
So do you have like a set time that you write every day, or is there like a routine?
Kind of. When the kids go to school and I have a quiet time with my two little dogs, I grab my coffee, I sit down and write as much as I can. And sometimes I write late into the night when it's very quiet.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. So I have a question about being an Asian American artist. Has that affected your work at all, or in terms of like the actual writing itself or working in the industry?
Honestly, I really don't know, but I do have to tell you a story that my brother's coworker, when they read the Steamier books, they picture the character as Asian, but they're not. But I thought that was kind of interesting.
Yeah, that is interesting. Yeah.
So are you working on new books right now, or what are your future projects?
Yes, I'm constantly working on new books. I have probably new two YA series that I'm working on, but I have an agent. She's wonderful, and I will be publishing a book through Vesuvian. I don't know if you can catch that right there, Vesuvian Media Group, and it's called Jacqueline and the Beanstalk. Not Jack, but Jacqueline. So I'm excited to wait and see when that comes out, hopefully next year.
And do you see any of your books getting made into movies?
Actually, when Crossroads came out, the fans have been emailing me asking for a movie, but at that time, when I finally got my rights back, I was a self-published author, and I didn't know anyone or who to turn to, but like I said, I have an agent now, so I let her know. So hopefully one day the series will become a movie.
Yeah.
I hope so too.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for doing this interview, and congratulations on all your success.
Thank you.
I'm Rachel Michiko-Whitney with Ideate TV.